Okay, thank you. Can you hear me? Yes. First, I will want to say that it's always a pleasure to come to Italy. This is, in fact, my second trip to Italy within 8 days. But I've not been to Sicily before, and having the Congress here was a nice opportunity to visit one of the most historically interesting places in whole Italy, in fact.
Sorry for the rain today.
Well, it doesn't change the history.
No, for the rain, per la pioggia.
Yes.
Okay.
Now I will present a study from the opposite part of Europe. In fact, if we consider this the southmost southern part of Europe, Norway is at the opposite part, at the northern part of Europe. And the study that I will present today is conducted in the northern part of Norway. So it's almost at the northern pole, practically speaking. For the last 10 years, I've been part of a group that have developed services for people with intellectual disability, autism, and psychiatric disorders in Norway. And when we started out 10 years ago, there was absolutely no instruments for assessment or any standards for treatment of these disorders in Norway, and also internationally, there were very few studies presenting topics in this area. So we were a group of clinicians at the Oslo University Hospital in the capital of Norway, Oslo, and more through need than lust, we became researchers because we needed a tool for the first step of assessment of psychiatric disorders in people with autism, because it's completely hopeless to give services without knowing the conditions. So, which I think has been very well presented by the two presenters previous to me today. Excuse me. This way. Here you see a map over Scandinavia, and Norway is at the left side, and the red area is the Nordland county in Norway, which this study took place. And that's why we call it in Norway the Nordland study. Norway is populated by less than 5 million people, so we are not many Norwegians. And Nordland county is a quite representative county in Norway. It has both rural and population, and one what we consider a rather large city, populated by approximately 60,000 people. That is a fair big city in Norway. The aims of the study was threefold. We wanted to estimate the prevalence of psychiatric disorders in adolescents and adults with autism and intellectual disability. And we wanted to compare the amount of psychiatric problems in both people with autism and intellectual disability and people with intellectual disability only, because it has been there has been hypothesis that people with autism have a lot more psychiatric problems than people with ID only. So we wanted to test this. And then we wanted to test the checklist that we have developed in our project group, the Psychopathology and Autism Checklist, in the population. As I told, the setting was the Nordland county, which has about 250,000 people. The measures was the Psychopathology and Autism Checklist, and the participants were the study group encompassing 62 persons with autism and intellectual disability. In fact, That was all the people with autism and intellectual disability in Nordland County known to the health and social system at the time when the data was collected. And we had no dropouts. So all the people in the study group that were asked to join the study, they took part. And that's, we were very pleased with that because, it, as you can see, it's not too many. And the reason we took the study group down to the age of 14 is that we have experienced in our clinical practice that what we call adult problems, that depression, psychosis, starts very early in the autism population. And that is also confirmed in other studies internationally. So we went down to the age of 14, and our control group encompassed 132 adolescents and adults with intellectual disability only. And that was a representative sample from five of the 44 municipalities in the Nordland County. I won't go through the psychopathology and autism checklist too carefully because this checklist is presented at this Congress in this poster, which is situated at the poster area, which is behind the bar at the second floor. I think it's in western direction, this direction. You can find the poster which describes the development of the psychopathology in checklist, autism checklist. And Sissel Helruskau, my colleague sitting there, is the master of this poster. Yes. The checklist is, as you can understand, not the assessment tool for diagnostic purposes. It's a checklist to spot the people that are potentially having a psychiatric disorder comorbid to autism and intellectual disability. And because assessment of these disorders in this population is so difficult, we have used rather large subscales, including many different psychiatric disorders. So we tried to spot psychosis, depression, anxiety, and OCD, and general adjustment problems. It is well known that people with autism and intellectual disability display a lot of challenging behavior, sleep problems, eat problems, unrest, and self-mutilation when they have trouble, when they have problems. But earlier it was believed that especially violent behavior or severely self-mutilation was a part of a psychotic condition. Now we know that it's not that easy. People with autism and intellectual disability, they might have a lot of general adjustment problems, challenging behavior, etc., without having psychiatric disorders. So that's why we included this subscale in the checklist, in order to separate people with a lot of trouble who are having psychiatric disorders and who are not having a psychiatric disorder.